Academies of Sugar Hill, and we will be performing a scene from Steel Magnolias.
Oops, I see a hole.
I was hoping you'd catch that.
It's a little poofier than I normally do, but I'm nervous.
I'm not too worried about that. Every night before I go to bed, I usually wrap my entire head up in toilet tissue, so that pushes it down a little anyways.
In my class at trade school, I was number one when it came to frosting and streaking. I did my own.
Really? I couldn't tell. And I can spot a bottle job at 20 paces. Well, your technique is good, and your form and content will improve the experience, so you're hired! And not a moment too soon, because we're about to be as busy as a one-armed paper hanger today.
Thank you, Mr. Ruby. Thank you.
No time for that. You know where the coffee stuff is. Everything else is next to the tray.
Oh, let me help you. You've got tiny hairs and fuzzies all over you.
There's so much static electricity in here, I pick up everything. Except boys and money. Be a treasure. And now, this is the most successful shop in town. Would you like to know why?
Why?
Because I've had a strict philosophy I've stuck to for the past 15 years. There's no such thing as natural beauty. Remember that or we're all out of a job. I mean, just take a good look at me now. I'd take some effort to look like this.
I can see that. How many ladies do we have coming in this morning?
Well, on Saturday mornings, I restrict myself to the ladies in the neighborhood. Normally, that's only three, but today we've got Shelby Eaton. She's not regular. She's the daughter of a regular. Today, she's getting married, so I gotta do something special with her hair.
Well, now, how long have you been in town?
A few weeks.
So you're new in town?
How exciting. Well, I wouldn't know. I've just lived here all my life.
It's a little bit scary.
I can imagine. Well, tell me things about yourself.
There's nothing to tell. I live here. I've got a job now. That's it. Can I borrow a few of these bath tissues of Southern hair?
Of course. It's essential to keep abreast of all the latest styles. I'm glad to see your interest. Now, you must live close by. Within walking distance, I mean, I didn't see a car.
I don't have a car. I've been across the river at Roebling's boarding house.
Why now? That's quite a walk. Ruth Roebling. Now there's a story. She's a twisted, troubled soul. Her whole life has been an experiment in terror. I gotta tell you, her husband was killed in World War II, son killed in Vietnam, between you and me. When she's right up there, when suffering, with Elizabeth Taylor.
I had no idea.
Oh!
Was that a gunshot?
Why, yes, dear, I believe it was. Plug in that hot plate, please.
But why is someone firing a gun in a nice neighborhood like this?
It has to do with Shelby Eaton and her wedding and her father. Trust me, you'll be happy if you ignore it, just like the rest of the neighborhood.
Knock, knock.
Well, hello. Good morning, Miss Clary.
Good morning, Truby.
Oh, a nail. I would like to introduce you to the former First Lady of Chickapin, Mrs. Belcher. Now, a nail. This is Clary. Clary, a nail. She's taking Truby's place.
Good to meet you.
I'm a little embarrassed. If I'd known I was meeting new people, I would have taken a little more pride in my appearance. What's your name, dear?
Well, my married name's DePoy.
I don't think I know any DePoys.
I just moved here.
That explains it.
Well, now, would you mind if I did Shelby first today?
That's fine. I'll amuse myself. Shelby's the most important one today.
Well, now, we're going to need some more towels. They're next to the wash machine.
Sweet girl, where'd you find her?
She heard I had a position open and walked right on in.
I think there's a story here.
What makes you say that?
For starters, she's married, but she's living over at Ruth Robelin's alone.
I'd get to the bottom of this if I were you. You have some nice silver right here you'd like to keep.
I'm not worried about that. She's real nice. I just love the idea of hiring somebody with a past.
She can't be more than 18. She hasn't had time to have a past.
Honey, it's the 80s. If you can't achieve puberty, you can't achieve a past.
Thank you.
Yuck.
Nell, how did you make this coffee?
I did like you said. I poured the water through the thing.
Where'd you get the water?
It was boiling on the stove.
Did you happen to notice the hot dog at the bottom of the pot?
No.
Make a new one, please.
I'm so sorry.
Don't worry. I love a good hot dog. Just not with cream and sugar.
Well, I reckon she's not an international spy. If she works out, I might just let her rent the garage apartment.
I thought the twins were going to live there. Why'd they go to college?
Recent developments. Louis going away to LSU, and who's decided to work for my cousin in Baltimore? And you don't want to be called Pooh no more. My babies are just grown up.
I can't believe your kids are old enough to leave the nest.
I was a child bride, do you remember? But I'm looking at the bright side. I
places I'd like to visit now. I've heard Baltimore's the hairdo capital of the world. Sometimes I wonder if Jerome Eaton's brain gets enough oxygen. That man is so annoying.
Try living next door to him.
Hi, everybody.
Well, there's my girl. Come bring money.
Hi, Trudy.
Morning, Miss Clarice. Not that I'm unfriendly. I'm just worried about my nails.
Well, now, that's a pretty color. Where's your mama?
Right behind me, I thought.
Hi, I'm Shelby Eatington.
Soon to be Latcherie.
I'm a nail, I'm new.
This is a nail's first day.
Well, a nail, you're working with the best. Anyone who's anybody gets their hair done at Truvy's.
That's absolutely right. Shelby, you know I'd walk on my lips to avoid criticizing anyone, but your father is about to make us all pull our hair out. Had for my business.
He should be done with his yard work soon.
I hope so.
You're not the only one concerned. Mama's about to have a fit. She and Daddy are fighting like cats and dogs.
Oh, they're just nervous with so much going on.
No, they're not. They just try to create as much tension as possible in any given situation. It's a creed they live by. Jackson and I will never fight about silly things.
Are you married or now?
I hope the coffee's better.
It smells right.
How pretty.
Princess Grace.
Oh, so you brought me those photos like I asked.
Here you go. Study them carefully. And here's the baby's breath.
Why, this is just so exciting. I feel I'm present at the creation. There's just something so wondrous about the way a bride looks. I feel its beauty in its purest form. Well, now, there ain't no baby's breath in this picture. Where am I supposed to put it?
You just stick it in. It's meant for my face. Baby's breath is part of my whole decoration concept for a total romantic look.
Oh, Miss Clary, what cute shoes.
Oh, you think so? Okay. I'm not so sure. I think they're a little too raised for me.
What?
I'll probably just give them away.
If you're just going to give them away, I'll open them from you.
What size do you wear?
Well, in a good shoe, I wear a size 6. 7 feels so good. I buy a size 8.
They're 8.5.
Perfect.
Hi, Mama. Look at me, Clary.
They're mine.
Is that a riddle?
Mm.
And Neil, this is my Mama. How are things at the house?
Fine. Weezer Boudreaux, just a second ago, Trout stopped by to talk to your father. One or both of them is probably lying in a pool by blood by now. Hi, did you say your name's Anna Lee?
That's a pretty name. I'm Lynn.
Well, now, how is our mother, the bride?
Don't ask.
What's the matter?
Nothing a handful of prescription drugs can't take care of.
Well, now, would you help Mrs. Eatington? These girls have mountains to move today.
Ain't that the truth? Let me take this for you.
Mama! This color is all wrong! It looks like I stuck piglet all over my hand.
I'm sure I have something that'll work.
But do you have pink?
Of course I have pink.
It has to be delicate.
I'll get it.
It's probably for me. It's probably my mind trying to locate my body.
Hello? Yes, there she is. Hold on a minute. Malin, it's your husband.
Yes, Jerome. I don't know. I don't have it. Jerome, if you're trying to drive me crazy, you're too late. For the last time, I don't have it. Ask the boys. Goodbye.
What did Daddy want?
Nothing. Well, now, we want to sweep it up, but keep some softness around your ears.
Sweep it up?
Yes, Mama. Up, like Princess Grace.
Did you bring Trudy the picture of Jacqueline Smith?
No, I brought a picture of Princess Grace.
But I thought I had made you understand the importance of this.
No, Mama.
Well, at least I talked you out of that stupid idea of putting that baby's breath in her hair.
Why now? Your mother hasn't told us much about Jackson, Shelby. What is he like?
Truthfully, I thought he was a pest at first. But then he kind of grew on me, and now I love him.
Well, now, he must be a real romantic.
No, but he brings me flowers. And little presents if I bug him enough. He has promised to bring me a red rose on every anniversary, corresponding to the number of that anniversary.
Well, that's a romantic idea now, isn't
it? Yes. I just wish it had been his.